सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्नायन्तं सिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So we are looking at the Purvapakshi Sutras. The next sutra is introduced by saying Jivasya api anutva shruti rasti ityah. So Jiva is said to be anu in some shruti. Therefore, Sarvavyapi is not the only shruti, but there is also anutva shruti for Jivas. Anuttam as Pramana. And thereby the next sutra, 22nd sutra of the Purvapakshi is Swashabdon Manabhyancha, Swashabdon Manabhyancha. So he says Swashabda Shruti by its own Swashabda says that Jivatma is Anu. And also by Unmana. So Unmana Abhyancha meaning also because there is a Mana comparison. There is a size comparison, and by that comparative also you know that Jivatma is Anu in size. So there are two Padas, there is no Padacheda beyond that. Esha Anuratma Iti Swasya Anutvasya Vachakaha Etat Shabdaha. So the Eshaha Anuhu Atma is a Shruti. Therefore, Swasya Anutvasya Vachakaha Etat Shabdaha, by its own word Shruti is saying, so there is Anutvasya. Swashabda is there, meaning Anushabda is there as a direct Shruti, and also Unmana, the comparison is there in sizes, therefore also Atma has Anu size. Says the Purvapakshi. So etat shabdaha, eshaha anu, etat shabda, eshaha is used, etat shabda is used to talk about atma. Which atma? This jivatma. So that atma, etat shabdaha, is equated with anu, and it is also in samana adhikran with atma. Then further what? Balagra shatabhagasya ityadi unmanam. Comparison of the atma is given. What is the size of atma? Bala agra shatabhagasya. So the comparison is that it is also the size of the hundredth, meaning shatabhaga. If you make the size of the hair, if you take a single hair strand of the hair and make the hundredth part of that, then it is smaller than that, or it is comparable to that. So there is a comparative also, ityadi unmanam. So two hetus are there. Shruti says anu with the anu shabda, swashabda, and also with the comparison with the balagra shatabhaga. Udrutya sarve biha stula parimane biha manam unmanam. What is unmanam? Unmanam is manam. It is Ma mane, to it is in the sense of the size, meaning of the size. So stula parimane bhiha manam sarvebhya udrutya, taking away every other size, there is a meaning stula parimana, taking away every stula parimana, there is a comparison given of atma. Thereby that size has to be Anu. So if you don't agree with the Anutva Shabda, because Anutva need not mean size also, it can mean something else also. That is what the Siddhanti may say. Therefore, the Purvapakshi is saying, okay, there is a comparison in size itself. So Unmana is there. Atyanta apakrushta parimanam iti yavat. So it is a very small size. That's what it means when Balagra Shatabhagasya is the Shruti Vakya. Tabhyam Hetubhyam. Because of these two Hetus, Jivaha Anu Eva, Anuhu Eva iti Artha. Therefore, Jiva is Anu, you cannot say there is no Shruti. Nanu Atmana Anutve Janhvi Toya Nimagnasya Deha Vyapi Shaityopalabdhi Virodha Ityatah. Purvapakshi is expecting a counter to this, as to if the Atma's size is Anu, then how would you get the Anubhava such as, oh, I feel cold when immersed in water, in Ganga water, Janhavi Toya Nimagnasya. For one who is immersed in Ganga water, how? He takes a complete dip. He immerses his head also. He immerses his entire head, entire body in the Ganga. And Ganga is always cold. Even in summer it is cold. The water is cold. So if at all, Nanu Atmanaha Anutve Sati. If Atma were to have Anu size, then Janhavi Toya Nimagnasya, one who is immersed, that person cannot have Deha Vyapi Shaitya Upalabdhi. That is the Virodha. But he does have. When he takes a dip in Ganga, then the entire body gets the feeling of chill. So the entire body has the feeling of the cold water. If the Atma is Anu, then how will it have sambandha with the entire Sharira to get the feeling all over? Only when you are where the feeling of cold is, then only you can say, I am cold. Or you have to say only, oh, I feel cold only in this part of the body. You apply ice on one part of the body, you don't feel the entire body is cold immediately. Over a period of time, if you keep on it, then you start feeling the chill. But then you put the piece of ice, let's say you banged your hand against something and then there is pain, you put a piece of ice so that the pain comes down. There only that part of the body, the hand, will feel the cold. But when you are immersed, you'll feel the cold. And why do you feel that? Even that part of the body, why do you feel? Only if you, what is Atma? Atma is your real Swarupa. So if you as Anu are in that part of the body, meaning you are in that part of the hand, then only you can say my hand is feeling cold. Let's say you are in that part of the body as Anu size, then you cannot say that part of the body is cold and then the rest of the body is warm. Because the rest of the body, you aren't there, associated with, you are not there at all. You are there only in a small part of the body. And it happens to be the part of the hand, because you want to argue that I feel the pain or I feel the cold because I am in that part of the body. Then you are not elsewhere. If you are not elsewhere, how can you feel that the rest of the body is without pain or is warm? Similarly, how will you feel that I am cold all over the body if your size is Anu, Atma's size is Anu? That is the argument that the Purvapakshi expects. So, Nanu Atmanaha Anutve Sati Janhavi Toya Nimagnasya Deha Vyapi Shaitya Upalabdhi Virodha Ityatah. That Anubhava Virodha is there. So, Virodha is in the form of Upalabdhi Anubhava of Shaitya. Where? Deha Vyapi. So that Shaitya, which is Deha Vyapi, इट इज ऑल ओवर दी परवेजिव ऑल ओवर दी बॉडी परवेडिंग ऑल ओवर दी बॉडी इत्यतः आह द नेक्स्ट सूत्र इज ऑल्सो पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र अविरोधश्चंदनवत अविरोधश्चंदनवत सो ही सेज अविरोधः हाउ चंदनवत ही सेज व्हेन यू अप्लाय चंदन दी शुद्ध चंदन ऑन दी फोरहेड व्हाई डू यू डू दैट यू डू इट बिकॉज इट इज ऑफर्ड टू भगवान एंड देन एज अलंकार ऑल्सो यू पुट इट ऑन योर फोरहेड बट वॉट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ दैट इट कूल्स डाउन द बॉडी सो ऑल्दो द चंदन इज पुट ऑन द फोरहेड यू फील द कोल्ड ऑल ओवर द बॉडी सो देर इज नो विरोध देर इज नो विरोध एट ऑल In fact, this should be the Purva Paksha to or question to the Purva Pakshi, but then he is giving this as an answer itself. He says, there is no Virodha, like Chandana, because it is Anubhava Siddha, like the sandal paste put on the forehead, but you feel cold all over the body. Yatha Chandana Binduhu, Sharira Eka Deshastaha, Sharira Eka Deshastaha, शरीरव्यापी सुखं जनयति तथा जीवोपि देहव्यापिनं शैत्याद्युपलम्भं करिष्यति इति अविरोधः इत्यर्थः सो ही इज रीडिंग एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट द वे यू आर रीडिंग मीनिंग ही इज कंक्लूडिंग द एग्जैक्ट अपोजिट टू व्हाट यूर कंक्लूजन इज इफ यू आस्क हिम हाउ डू यू फील द एंटायर बॉडी ही सेज चंदना इज In one part of the body, but even being in one part of the body, it pervades through and through the entire sharira. Chandana pervades entire sharira by gandha also and by the effect of cooling as well. Similarly, atma also can be in one part of the body, but its function is throughout the body. It can be in the hridaya akasha, but still it is deha vyapi. Just like Chandana is Sharira Vyapi Sukham Janaka, similarly Sukasya Janaka, Sukha Janaka. So the way Chandana Bindu is Sukha Janaka or Sukasya Janaka, where Sharira Vyapi Sukasya Janaka. Similarly, Atma is also having Anubhava of the entire Sharira, although it is in one part of the body. So this is how he is giving an Udharana. यथा चंदन बिंदु शरीर सन इवन बीइंग इन वन पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी दिस चंदन बिंदु द डॉट ऑफ चंदन जस्ट अ स्मॉल पोर्शन लाइक अ बिंदु विच इज अ ड्रॉप जस्ट अ डॉट दैट यू फॉर्म ऑन योर फोरहेड शरीर व्यापी सुखं जनयति इट जनरेट्स द सुख ऑफ कूलिंग इफेक्ट थ्रू आउट द बॉडी तथा जीव अपि Similarly, this jivatma dehavyapinam shaityadyupalambam karishyati. This jiva will also do what is the problem? He can be in one part of the body, hridaya akash or wherever, and then have anubhava throughout the body, dehavyapinam, shaityadi, cold, etc. Iti aviroda, therefore there is no viroda, he has given an udharana. Drishtanta darshtantikayur vaishamyam ashankya parihariti. Now he says that Purvapakshi expects a question or a counter to this as in the drishtanta and darshtantika there is vaishamya there is a difference between the two chandana is one in one place and it has a sarvavyapi effect versus atma being in one place and having the sarvavyapi result both are different from each other thereby he says अवस्थिति वैशेष्याद इति चेन नाभ्युपगमाद धृदिहि अवस्थिति वैशेष्याद इति चेन नाभ्युपगमाद धृदिहि अवस्थिति वैशेष्यात इति चेत न अभ्युपगमाद हृदि ही सो ही सेज अवस्थिति वैशेष्यात इफ एट ऑल से इफ एट ऑल दी Counter to the Purva Pakshi is avasthiti vishesha, vaisheshya, meaning visheshattvam. Meaning this avasthiti, the existence, wherever the placement of the chandana is versus wherever the atma is present, that is the avasthiti. And avasthitehe vaisheshyat, because of the particularity of that, due to that, iti chet. If this be argued, then abhyupagamad. Why? Because this argument is not a counter at all. Why? Because this is abhyupagamad, hridihi abhyupagamad, because in the heart the atma is accepted to be by the Shruti itself and by Darsharikas also. Hridaya akashe, atma is there. Therefore, hridihi, this is, so avasthiti, there is no difference in the avasthiti of the chandana bindu at one place and avasthiti of atma in another place, because it is just a particular place, that's all. There is no difference between this particularity. You cannot say that one is at the forehead and the other is at the, it does not have a place, particular place. There is a place for atma also. So therefore, drishtant and darshtantika vaishamya cannot be an argument, says the Purvapakshi. So it will be further clear when we look at the vritti. Natra chandana drishtantaha, why avasthiti vaisheshyat? There is this particular desha that is shown with the chandana example cannot hold good, because atma does not have such a particular place discussed, is the counter. So therefore you cannot use chandana drishtanta, is an objection to the Purvapakshi. Pratyakshena chandana bindoho ekadeshe avasthiti jnayate, jivasya tu na evam iti atulyatvad iti chetna. So what is the meaning there? He says that jiva's place is not known clearly, but chandana's place is known clearly because of pratyaksha pramana functioning there. In the case of jivatma, there is no pratyaksha pramana. Therefore, chandana bindoho ekadeshe avasthiti hi jnayate pratyakshena, pratyakshena pramanena. So pratyaksha pramana leads to your knowledge that chandana is on the forehead. There is no argument there. Similarly, can you say that jivatma is in a particular place? There is no pratyaksha pramana. So this is the objection that the Purvapakshi expects. But he says shabda pramana is there. Jivastu na evam iti atulyatva, there is atulyatvam between the drishtanta and darshtantika, iti chet na, says the Purvapakshi. Why? Kutaha abhyupagamat, jivanutvasya abhyupagamat, because this jiva has been accepted as anu earlier and you have to accept a place, particular place. Which is that particular place? Hridihi tat kasmat. So jiva is anu has already been proven in the earlier sutras as per the Purvapakshis. Now he says that the place has to be expected, has to be accepted, expected also and accepted also. It has to be expected because jiva is anu, it has to be expected in a particular place. What is that particular place? Hridi. So if you don't accept that jiva is anu also, it is fine, says the Purvapakshi. Let's say you have not accepted that the jiva is anu, because I am trying to prove that now. But hridaya deshe, hridayi, hridaya deshe, hridakashe, hridayakashe, these are some words which are used in the Shruti. Angushtamatra purusha, and we have seen how this angushtamatratvam is related to the fist. Within the fist, the angushta size rests. Size of the angushta is the space within, and that space within is comparable to the hridaya akasha, because hridaya is also of that particular shape and size of the palm of the folded fist. Therefore, this hridaya akasha is mentioned directly or indirectly in the Shruti itself. That is where this jivatma is. Now if the jivatma has to be in that place, it has to be anu, it cannot be vibhu. So other way the hetu works, tat kasma. That's why he has used the hetu as hridi. He is the hetu for jivasya anutva abhyupagama, for acceptance of jiva as anu. It has been accepted in the shastra. Whether you accept it or not is a different story, says the Purvapakshi to Siddhanti. Yasmat alpa parimane hridi jivaha patyate hridyantarjyotihi ityadav. In mantras such as hridyantarjyoti, hridi antarjyotihi, this effulgent being is within the हार्ट, स्पेस ऑफ द हार्ट, दैट इज हाउ दिस जीवात्मा पठ्यते इज स्टडीड इन द श्रुति एंड दैट हृत स्पेस ऑफ हृत इज वॉट अल्प परिमाण इन दैट अल्प परिमाण हृत इन दैट लिमिटेड स्पेस ऑफ द हार्ट इज द जीवात्मा सो दिस इज हाउ इट इज चैंटेड इन द श्रुति हाउ कैन यू से दैट जीवा डज नॉट हैव अणुत्व साइज इट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेड इट इज एक्सेप्टेड इत्यादो तस्मात् देयरफॉर व्हाट जीवस्य अणुत्वम् अभ्युपगम्यते इति न दृष्टांत वैषम्यम् इत्यर्थः देयरफॉर यू कैन नॉट से दैट चंदना इज इन वन पर्टिकुलर प्लेस विच इज नोन एंड आत्मा इज नॉट नोन टू बी इन अ पर्टिकुलर प्लेस दैट कैन नॉट बी आर्ग्यूमेंट टू शो दैट देर इज अ दृष्टांत दार्ष्टांतिक वैषम्य देर इज नो वैषम्य सेज द पूर्वपक्षी ननु सावयवतया चंदन बिंदु हो सर्वशरीर व्यापकत्वम् न तथा जीवस्य अणु हो सावयवत्वम् येन शरीर व्यापित्वम् स्याद् इति अपरितुष्ट्या पक्षांतरमः पूर्वपक्षी हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट हैप्पी विद द आर्ग्यूमेंट ही हैज मेड ही इज नॉट कंप्लीटली सैटिस्फाइड ही सेज दैट आई विल यूज अनदर मेथडोलॉजी बिकॉज अपरितुष्टि इज देयर ही इज नॉट कंप्लीटली सैटिस्फाइड देयरफॉर ही गिव्स अनदर पक्ष पक्षांतरम अन्य पक्ष पक्षांतरम वाई इज ही नॉट हैप्पी सो ननु सावयवतया चंदन बिंदो हो सर्व शरीर व्यापकत्वम नाउ दिस चंदना मे रीच द एंटायर बॉडी दिस इज वॉट पूर्व पक्षी इज थिंकिंग एज एन आर्ग्यूमेंट दैट इज पॉसिबल सो ही इज हिमसेल्फ थिंकिंग This can be a Purvapaksha. He himself can raise a Purvapaksha and say, oh, Chandana example may be Vishama to the Darshtantika, exemplified Atma. How? Because Atma is partless, whereas Chandana has parts. Therefore, one may say that you feel the cooling effect in the entire body because the parts of the Chandana pervade the body. Although you apply it on the forehead, the parts... There may be very atomic particles which enter the skin and then they pervade the body. That is what, you know, these patches are also, you know, you have these medication patches. The new age medication patches or, you know, I think people use for, you know, to leave smoking. They have these patches, nicotine patch or something. And similarly, you know, new age medicine, there is also, you know, you don't have to take it intravenous, you don't have to, you know, take pills also, they'll put a patch. But that is not local, need not necessarily be local. It can be local also, but it can pervade the entire body also. The medicine goes through the skin, through the perforations, and then it goes and reaches all around the body. Similarly, this chandana, which has parts, like the medicine parts, chandana parts can also reach across the body, throughout the body, and therefore you feel a cooling effect. This can be their argument. Therefore that example cannot be used as there is an example and exemplified Vaishamya. This is the argument. There is a difference because Atma does not have parts. So parts of the Atma cannot pervade all over the body, reach all over the body to feel the Shaitya when one is immersed in the Ganga water. न तथा जीवस्य अणोः सावयवत्वम् सो दिस जीवा हु इज अणु एज पर दी पूर्व पक्षी दैट अणु जीवा कैनॉट हैव पार्ट्स सो इज नॉट सावयव मीनिंग आत्मा इज दैट आत्मा इज नॉट सावयव इज नॉट विथ पार्ट्स इट इज पार्टलेस सावयवत्वम् न येन शरीर व्यापित्वम् स्याद् ड्यू टू विच द पूर्व पक्षी कैन क्लेम दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर आत्मा with its parts is reaching all over the body. He cannot make such a claim because he also knows that Atma is partless and what is Hetu? Anutva itself will become a Hetu. And therefore he himself is not satisfied and thereby through dissatisfaction, his own dissatisfaction, aparitushtya, pakshantarmaha, he himself gives another option. Gunadva lokavat. So he says, gunat, वा लोकवत यथालोके, लोकवत मीन्स यथालोके, जस्ट लाइक इट इज सीन इन द प्रपंच. वॉट इज सीन दैट द गुण, बिकॉज ऑफ गुण, वॉट काइंड ऑफ अ गुण, ज्ञान इत्यादि. सो ज्ञान इज अ गुण. सो दिस गुण, वेन यू लुक एट दिस गुण, वेन यू लुक एट घट, घट हैज वॉट, घट हैज सम गुण. वेर इज दिस गुण? घट हैज लेट से घटत्व एज अ सामान्य धर्म गुण, और लेट से दी पॉट इज ब्राउन. सो वेर इज दिस नीलत्व? सो नीलो घट, यू सी नीलो घट. सो नीलो घट मीन्स वॉट? नील गुणवान घट. सो घट हैज नील गुण. वेर वेर डज घट हैव नील गुण? इट हैज थ्रू एंड थ्रू, डज नॉट हैव गुण एट वन प्लेस. एंड दिस गुण इज पार्टलेस, गुण डज नॉट हैव पार्ट्स. सो दैट कैन बी एन एग्जाम्पल वेर गुण इज पार्टलेस एंड आत्मा इज ऑल्सो पार्टलेस. अनलाइक माई अर्लियर एग्जाम्पल सेज द पूर्व पक्षी, वेर माई चंदन एग्जाम्पल was such that the chandana was savayava, whereas atma is niravayava. But here guna is niravayava and atma is niravayava, that can be an example. So guna is seen through and through the ghata. So one example, you can take another example, vritti will give another. Similarly is this atma, although being anu, it is available everywhere. Atmanah anutve api तन्निष्ठ ज्ञान गुणस्य व्यापकत्वांगीकारात् व्यापकगुणाद्यापि व्यापक गुणाद् व्यापी कार्यं भविष्यति. सो ही सेज हाउ डज दिस वर्क इफ यू लुक इनटू डिटेल्स, हाउ डज आत्मा हैव शैत्य अनुभव, मीनिंग हाउ डज अ पर्सन हु इज इमर्स्ड इन द गंगा, ऑल्दो हिज स्वरूप इज अणु, आत्मस्वरूप जी एज जीवा जीवात्मा, हिज स्वरूप इज अणु, परिमाण इज अणु, एंड ही इज इन दी हृदेश. बट हाउ डज ही हैव दी ज्ञान, मीनिंग दी अनुभव. ज्ञान एंड अनुभव आर अभिन्न 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 अर्थ का शब्द. ज्ञान एंड अनुभव हैव द सेम मीनिंग. सो हाउ डज ही हैव अनुभव ऑफ द शैत्य विच इज ऑल परवेसिव इन द बॉडी, द एंटायर बॉडी इज फीलिंग द कोल्ड, ऑल्दो ही इज ओनली इन दी हृदाकाश. That is because jnana is a guna which has all pervasive reach, and that jnana is atma guna. Tarkikas also say jnana, every jnana ityadi, all these gunas are atma gunas, and you feel in the antakrana because antakrana and the atma sambandha is there, whatever is the sambandha, tadatmya or whatever sambandha that the Siddhanti were to argue, some sambandha is there. If there is some sambandha, then that sambandha places the atmagata jnana guna into the antakkarana, and then you have this kind of a vritti etc. kind of argument. So similarly, the shaitya anubhava is because the jnana is a guna which is having a pervasive reach, just like we saw that the guna of ghata has a pervasive reach throughout the ghata. So this is the argument that the Purvapakshi is making through this 25th sutra. Atmana anutve api tannishta jnana gunasya, meaning tan atmanishta jnana gunasya. Jnana is Atmanishta, it is a guna and it is Atmanishta, it is in Atma. Therefore, Vyapakatva Angikarat, Tasya Gunasya, which guna? Jnana guna. That Jnana guna is Vyapaka guna. We have already seen with the example. So, Vyapakatva Angikarat, Vyapaka gunad. Therefore, what this Vyapaka guna, due to this Vyapaka guna, Vyapi Karyam Bhavishyati. This Vyapi Karya meaning what? The all pervasive jnana of the entire shaitya in the entire sharira is possible. Bhavishyati will be possible, will be made possible due to this kind of a guna बिहेवियर, बिहेवियर ऑफ द गुणा, लोकवत यथा लोके, जस्ट लाइक इट इज सीन इन द वर्ल्ड. व्हाट इज द एग्जांपल ही गिव्स? वृत्ति सेज गृहनिष्ठ प्रदीपस्य अल्पत्वेपि प्रभात्मक गुणवशात् गृहव्यापी प्रकाशादि कार्यम संभवति तद्वदित्यर्थ. बिकॉज विथ माय एग्जांपल आल्सो वैषम्य कैन बी क्लेम घटा एंड घटगुण घटगत गुण. सो ही इज गिविंग एन एग्जांपल ऑफ दैट विच इज प्रत्यक्ष बट इट इज आल्सो सटल. वेयर यू कैन आर्ग्यू एज टू the result is not separate from the pratyaksha. The result itself is pratyaksha, meaning the guna itself is pratyaksha elsewhere. That is the argument that can be made with the ghata and the neelatva guna. The neelatva guna is all pervasive, you see it. So how can you say that this neelatva guna is one place? That can be an argument. So Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra uses a better example. He says, look at the prabha. This prabha, the prakasha, which is this prakasha, grihanishta pradipasya alpatvyapi. So you have lit up a lamp in the house. So let's say there is a power cut or something, and you have lit up a lamp, or it is in the puja room, you have lit up a lamp. So that pradipasya alpatvyapi, that pradipa is very small. It's a small flame of the lamp. And even then, alpatvyapi prabha atmaka guna vashad, because this prabha is what? By swarupa it is guna. Because of that, what? Gruhavyapi prakasha adhikaryam sambhavati. Still, this lamp lights up the entire place. If the house is bigger, then for prakasha you will light a bigger lamp. Modern day example can be a bigger wattage bulb. So you'll use a bigger wattage bulb or a tube light, and then the entire room is lit up. Although the prabha is the guna of that bulb or the tube light, the lamp. So although the prabha is the guna of the of that particular lamp, still it has a far-reaching vyapi karya. That prabha reaches everywhere. Similarly, what this jnana is an atma guna, although atma is in hriddesha, still it has a deha vyapi karya of getting the entire sharira shaitya jnana. Tadvat ityartha. That is the example. Therefore, there is no vaishamya, and now there is Parituṣṭi for the Pūrvapakṣi. Nanu guṇī vyatirekena guṇasya vṛttehe anyatra adarśanāt tat katam ityāśaṅkyāḥ. Now the Pūrvapakṣi is countered by an objection. Guṇī vyatirekena guṇasya vṛttehe anyatra adarśanāt. There is no anubhava, or it is not seen. What is not seen? This guna is not seen separate from the guni elsewhere. You don't see the vritti or pravritti of any guna elsewhere other than the guni. Guni vyatirekena gunasya vrittehe anyatra darshanam nasti. Never have you seen guna separate from the guni at all. Therefore, how is it that you use such an example of prabha? Because prabha is not other than the bulb, meaning the other than the lamp there is no prabha. That prabha is one with the lamp. There is no guna guni bheda actually. Nonetheless, you have differentiated. Now where do you see this guna separately from the guni? You would never see it. So how can you give such an example? Ask the Pūrvapakṣi to the Pūrvapakṣi. So there the Pūrvapakṣi replies by the next sutra, Vyatireko Gandhavat. Vyatireko Gandhavat. Just before that, I want to mention this व्यापकत्व अंगीकार ऑल्सो देर इज दिस व्यापकत्व अंगीकार मेंशन इन दी वृत्ति टू द अर्लियर सूत्र देर दीज रामानुजास मीनिंग विशिष्टाद्वैतिन्स दे ऑल्सो से दैट आत्मा इज अणु एंड इवन इफ आत्मा इज अणु ज्ञान इज व्यापी सो वॉट इज देयर ऑब्जेक्शन टू अद्वैत पक्ष सो विशिष्ट अद्वैतीन से दैट अद्वैतीन्स हैव मिसअंडरस्टूड मीनिंग यूजिंग दिस वृत्ति हियर ऑफ द पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र विच इज हाउ दी विशिष्ट अद्वैतन्स ऑल्सो अंडरस्टैंड दैट आत्मा इज अणु एंड इवन इफ आत्मा इज अणु ज्ञान इज व्यापी द गुणा इज व्यापी हैज अ व्यापी कार्य एंड ड्यू टू दिस व्यापी कार्यस अद्वैतिन्स हैव सैडली मिसकनक्लूडेड एज टू आत्मा इज सर्वव्यापी और सर्वज्ञ आत्मा ज्ञाता इति मन्यन्ते भ्रांतितः भ्रांतितः अद्वैतिनः दिस इज व्हाट दे थिंक सेज दी विशिष्ट अद्वैतीन टू दी अद्वैतीन और टू एक्सप्लेन दी मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द अद्वैतीज ही सेज दैट आत्मा ऑल्दो इट इज अणु इट कैन सीम टू बी व्यापक तत्व वाई बिकॉज द ज्ञान इज ऑल परवेसिव ज्ञान एंड दैट ऑल परवेसिव ज्ञान इज नॉट रियली सो इट इज मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग बिकॉज आत्मा is limited in one place but atma guna jnana makes you think that you are all over so some kind of an argument is made by the vishishta dvaitins which falls in this kind of a purvapaksha here purvapaksha sutra now further what do the tarkikas say about this So this vyapaka gunadi karya is what the shitoshna upalabdhi ityadi. That is the meaning of this vyapaka guna gunad vyapikaryam. Vyapikaryam is this a feeling of the sharira being, sharira experiencing shaitya when immersed in janavitoya, in Ganga water. So that is due to that, just like that example, is used so siddhantis advaitins have misconcluded they have concluded wrongly say the vishishta advaitins because of this anubhava you cannot make such a claim atma can still be anu so that was the earlier sutra the next sutra objection we have seen as to guna vyatirekana gunasya vritte anyatra adarshanat you never see the guna separate from the guni elsewhere therefore this argument or this sutra that purvapakshi gave is not acceptable therefore purvapakshi says vyatireko gandhavat vyatireko gandh vyatirekah gandhavat vyatireka so gandha so he says we'll look at the vritti directly it's a small vritti anyway so no point in repeating so vyatireka is counter example the counter so he is countering that with like gandha यथा गुणस्यापि सतः गंधस्य गुणि व्यतिरेकण वृत्ति ही सेज दैट दिस गुण ऑफ गंध गंध इज अ गुण ऑफ नॉट गंध गंध इज ऑल्सो गुण बट दी चंदन लेट्स से चंदन गंध इज अ गुण लाइक दी चंदन लेट्स टेक दी चंदन एग्जांपल इटसेल्फ सो चंदन has gandha as the guna chandana is prithvi tattva so prithvi tattva means prithvi it is prithvi padartha so gandhavati prithvi now this gandhavati prithvi means gandha gunavati prithvi and in the example of chandana what will it mean gandhavan or gandhavat chandanam gandhavat chandanam napunchakalinga so gandhavat chandanam chandanam is guni and Gandha is guna. Now your claim, meaning the objection as an introduction, the sutra claimed that guna is not seen separate from the guni. There the Purvapakshi is saying that what do you do see? You have a counter example. I'll give you a counter. One example is sufficient. He says that Chandana is placed in the puja room, but you smell it outside also. Chandana is not moving. What does he say? Chandana is there in the puja room or in the temple, but outside temple with the deity in the garbhagudi. And that Chandana smell, which is a gandha, which is a guna, that is experience outside. You smell the gandha outside. So how do you say that guna anubhava is not there, guna darshana is not there, other than the guni? It is other than the guni. You don't have to go and smell the chandana itself. The smell is there, further there also. It is available outside the garbhagudi also, outside the puja room also. Therefore, vyatireka, gandhavat vyatireka, vyatireka udharanam asti, vyatireka drishtanta asti. So, yatha gunasyapi sataha gandhasya, that gandha which is a guna, definitely even being a guna, this gandha even being a guna has vritti which is guna vyatireka. Guna vyatirekena vritti asti. Kasya vritti asti gandhasya. Kidrashaha sa gandha which is guna. So guna gunasya api sataha. So guna san api gandha. Guni vyatirekena vartate is seen separate than the guni chandana. So this gandha is anubhuta other than the gandhavat chandana. Therefore, guni chandana is not the only place where you will have anubhava of gandha. You can smell that gandha outside also, far away also. Therefore, he says what? Vyatireka example is there. Your objection does not hold good, says the Purvapakshi. Pushpa petikataha dure paryatataha pumsaha gandho upalambha darshanat. So example given is the this gandha example that I gave with the chandana. This vritti uses a different example. He says you are passing by a garden which has many roses. Do you smell the rose or not? You don't have to go inside the garden and you know smell the rose. You or a market, flower market. You pass by the flower market. You don't have to know that it is a flower market. You know it anyway. Or you pass by the Satara Kolhapur belt on highway. You are driving or you are going by a bus. You pass the sugarcane factories. You have Durgandha. That's another example. Do you have to really go to the factory? You don't have to go. You know it within. Or in Mumbai, many examples you have all over this filthy smell. You don't have to go and smell. You get it anyway. And that is without the padartha reaching you, only the guna is there which is reaching. Guni is not reaching. Therefore, guna can be seen separately from the guni. What is the problem there? Tadvat guni vyatirekah jnanasya ityarth. Similarly, jnana can be said as separate from the guni. Atma does not have to move. Atma can be in the hridakasha, hridayadesha, and the atmagata jnana guna can have a all-pervasive reach, and although partless, it can go elsewhere throughout the body, and then you can feel the jnana of the shaitya, which is all pervasive in the body. There is no problem there. So I have resolved this, says the Purvapakshi. But is it really true? You have to ask the Tarkika. Tarkika says that guna guni have a samavaya sambandha. So guna guni having a samavaya sambandha, they can never be separate from each other. Guna cannot exist without the guni, guni cannot exist without the guna. Guna asya asti asmin va iti matup. That matup pratyaya has been added as guna is there in that, or that entity has guna. गंधा इन दिस केस. सो गंधवती पृथ्वी, पृथ्वी कैनॉट बी सीन सेपरेटली फ्रॉम गंधा, गंधा कैनॉट बी सीन सेपरेट फ्रॉम द पृथ्वी एट ऑल. सो व्हाट अबाउट दिस एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द पुष्पा इत्यादि, वी हैव सीन इन द तर्क संग्रह विद्धि पदकृत्य टीका एज टू दिस गंधा रीचेस अ पर्टिकुलर प्लेस विद द पार्टिकल, स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स, पार्ट्स ऑफ द गुणी रीच द पर्सन हिज इंद्रिया, हिज ऑल्फैक्टरी ऑर्गन इज रीच्ड बाय दीज पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द गुणी. सो वेर एवर एज फार एज यू स्मेल द चंदना और द पुष्पा, सो फार द पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द चंदना एंड द पुष्पा हैव ट्रेवल्ड एंड दैट पार्टिकल इज दैट गुणी. वेर द गुणा ऑफ द गंधा इज देर, therefore the gandha is anubhuta, experienced by the person. You smell the essence of chandana because the chandana particles have reached your nose and the ghranendriya. This is what the tarkikas say, and we have seen then why don't you see holes in the pushpa ityadi arguments we have seen there. Says that based on the prarabdha they are filled up by Ishvara. So anyway, coming back to this argument as to the question of the objection to the Purvapakshi being countered by the example of the Chandana Gandha Guna being separate from the Guni or the Pushpa, Pushpa Gandha being separate from the Guni Pushpa because you smell it at a distance, that is not right. Anyway, it is not covered here, it is because it is a Purvapakshi Sutra. Adhuna jnanena eva atmanaha dehavyaptir ityatra shrutimaha. Now what is being done is that the shrutimaha, the Purvapakshi gives a shruti as what? As to establish what? Jnanena eva atmanaha dehavyaptihi. This dehavyapti is by jnana. That atma, which is jnana, jnana is a guna of that atma. So deha vyapti is there. Jnaneneva atmana, atmanaha. So jnana rupene we can take. Jnana, atma is pervading the body, not literally, but through the jnana. And thereby this deha vyapti is there. Pervasiveness throughout the body. Tathacha darshayati. तथा च दर्शयति सेज दी पूर्व पक्षी. नो पदच्छेद देर दि श्रुति ऑल्सो शोज इन अ सिमिलर मैनर दैट आई एम आर्ग्यूइंग हाउ हृदय आयतनत्व हृदय आयतनत्वम अणुपरिमाणत्वम च आत्मनः अभिधाय तस्यैव आलोमभ्य आलखाग्रेभ्य इति श्रुतिः ज्ञानेन समस्त शरीर व्यापित्वम दर्शयति इत्यर्थः. थ्रू दिस ज्ञान Atma has pervaded the body. Although Atma is Anu, through this Jnana Guna it has pervaded the body, shows the Shruti itself. How? A-lomabhyaha, A-lakhagrebhyaha. Loman is, means the hair. And Nakha is in, are the nails. So, up to the strands of the hair, the root of the hair. Up to the root of the hair and up to the nails, the beginning of the nails, the again root of the nails. So much is the pervasion of the Atma. How? Through jnana. When you cut the nails or you cut the hair, you do not know that it is cut unless you have pratyaksha pramana, which is outside this anubhava of pain. You see that the hair has been cut, you see that the nails have been cut. Or you feel by touch. But anything within that, within those boundaries of the root of the hair and the root of the nails, Atma is pervasive. Whatever feeling is there, that feeling is throughout, up to the root of the hair and root of the nails. Jnana is pervading and through that jnana samasta sharira vyapitvam kasya atmanah darshayati. Atmana sarva vyapitvam, sarva samasta sharira vyapitvam. आत्मा परवेड्स ऑल ओवर द शरीर थ्रू दिस ज्ञान. दैट ज्ञान इज परवेडिंग. हाउ मच इज इट परवेडिंग? इट इज परवेडिंग अप टू द रूट ऑफ द हेयर एंड रूट ऑफ द नेल्स. द श्रुति इटसेल्फ सेज दैट. सो हृदय आयतनत्वम अणुपरिमाणत्वम च आत्मना अभिधाय. सो जस्ट बिकॉज इट्स आलोमभ्य अनखाग्रेभ्य सिद्धांति शुड नॉट क्लेम दैट दैट इज अ मंत्र विच इज शोइंग आत्मा इज ऑल परवेसिव. पूर्व पक्षी सेइंग दैट आत्मा इज अणु इन दी हृदय आकाश बट दी ज्ञान विच इज द आत्मगुण इज ऑल परवेसिव. दैट इज वॉट दी श्रुति इज सेइंग देयर. वाई? बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी एस्टैब्लिश्ड. वॉट? हैविंग एस्टैब्लिश्ड समथिंग. अभिधाय किम अभिधाय? आत्मनः हृदय आयतनत्वम एंड अणुपरिमाणत्वम च. सो एंड ऑल्सो द साइज ऑफ आत्मा बीइंग अणु दैट श्रुति हैज ऑलरेडी शोन. सो हैविंग शोन दैट आत्मा इज इन द हृदय देश हृदय आयतनम इट रेस्ट इन द हृदय एंड आत्मा हैज अणुपरिमाणत्वम इट हैज अ अणु साइज. हैविंग शोन दैट देन श्रुति सेज आलोमभ्य अनखाग्रेभ्य. देयरफोर ज्ञानेन ओनली थ्रू ज्ञान गुण ऑफ आत्मा हैज द आत्मा हैज द श्रुति शोन द परवेसिवनेस ऑफ आत्मा. सो आत्मा इज नॉट रियली परवेसिव. इट इज इन द हृदेश बट ज्ञान इज ऑल परवेसिव एंड थ्रू दिस ज्ञान आत्मा इज सेट टू बी परवेसिव. दिस इज वॉट दी श्रुति दर्शयति इत्यर्थः. तत्र एव हेत्वंतरम. दिस इज द लास्ट पूर्वपक्षी सूत्र इन दिस सेक्शन. क्वाइट अ लॉन्ग सेक्शन ऑफ पूर्वपक्षी सूत्रस. द ओनली सेक्शन वेयर सच लॉन्ग सीक्वेंस ऑफ पूर्वपक्षी सूत्रस आर देयर. तत्र एव हेत्वंतरम आह. एंड देयर इटसेल्फ विद द श्रुति इंटरप्रिटेशन एज शोन ही गिव्स अनदर रीजनिंग ऑल्सो. हेतु पृथक उपदेशात. पृथक उपदेशात ड्यू टू वॉट? ड्यू टू टीचिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस ऑल्सो. वॉट इज दैट टीचिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस? प्रज्ञया शरीरम समारुह्य इति आत्म ज्ञानयोः कर्तृकरण भावेन पृथक उपदेशात. पूर्वपक्षी सेज देर इज अ डिफरेंस. पृथक उपदेश इज वॉट? उपदेश ऑफ पृथक्त्वम. टीचिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस. डिफरेंस बिटवीन वॉट एंड वॉट? डिफरेंस बिटवीन द गुण एंड गुणी. डिफरेंस बिटवीन ज्ञान एंड आत्मा. ज्ञान एज गुण एंड आत्मा एज गुणी. वाई? बिकॉज सिद्धांति इज सेइंग दैट आत्मा इज ज्ञान. ज्ञान इज आत्मा. इट्स अ लक्षण ऑफ आत्मा. पूर्व पक्षी सेज नो नो इट इज नॉट. वाई? बिकॉज गुणगुणी भाव इज देर बिकॉज देर इज अ टीचिंग ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन ज्ञान एंड आत्मा. प्रज्ञया शरीरम समारुह्य थ्रू दिस प्रकर्षज्ञ. प्रज्ञया प्रज्ञा विल बिकम प्रज्ञा. प्रकर्ष ज्ञानम ज्ञा. सो प्रज्ञा इज वॉट? प्रज्ञा इज ज्ञानम. एंड थ्रू दैट प्रज्ञा मीनिंग थ्रू द ज्ञान शरीरम समारुह्य. हैविंग यू नो लिटरली यू कैन से हैविंग माउंटेड द शरीर. Meaning having reached the sharira, having reached the entire sharira through prajna. Meaning what? Jnanena samasta sharira vyapakatvam. So there is such prithak upadesha also because prajna ya is in tritiya. And that is karne tritiya. Through the jnana as an instrument, as a tool, as a means. Atma samaruhya, shariram samaruhya, atma, jivatma. Therefore, there is a difference between jivatma and prajna, which is jnana. Iti atma jnana yo kartru karana bhavena. Prajna or jnana is karana and atma is karta. Therefore, kartru karana bhava has been shown with another shruti. And thereby what? Prithak upadesha is. Karta and karana are not same. Karta and karana are different. You are not the spoon or the hand with which you eat. You are the eater and the spoon is the karana. The hand is the karana. Similarly, that prithaktvam is shown, difference is shown between karta and karana by prajna shariram samaruhya atma. So atma is the karta there and prajna or jnana is the karana. Thereby what? Gunadvara asya sharira vyapitvam gamyate. It is known gamyate, avagamyate. किम अवगम्यते शरीर व्यापित्वम कस्य आत्मन अस्य अस्य आत्मन दिस वेरी आत्मा हैज व्हाट शरीर व्यापित्वम हैज अ रीच थ्रू आउट दी शरीर हाउ गुण द्वारा गुण ज्ञान गुण द्वारा प्रज्ञा रूप ज्ञान गुण द्वारा शोज दी श्रुति तथा च व्यापकम ज्ञानम जीवस्तु अणु इति अणुत्व श्रुत्या सर्वगतत्व श्रुतेः विरोधः इति पूर्वपक्षः देयरफॉर पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट थ्रू एज मेनी सूत्रास थ्रू सम 10 सूत्रास आई हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट व्हाट इज व्यापक इज ज्ञान नॉट आत्मा बट श्रुति सेज सर्वव्यापी आत्मा आल्सो देयरफॉर दैट सर्वगतत्व श्रुति has viroda with this anutva shruti or these anutva shrutis that I have shown anutva shruti is there and then I have established through other shrutis also as to why we can infer or have linga as to anutva parimana of atma so vyapaka is jnana atma is not vyapaka because we have seen anutva shruti also so now you have sarvavyapi shruti on one hand and anutva shruti on the other hand There is definite viroda among these two. Jivastu anuhu iti anutva shrutya sarvagatatva shrutye viroda iti purvapaksha. There is definitely contradiction between these two. So what is the counter? How will you resolve this? So where is he coming from? Just as a reminder, where is the purvapakshi coming from in this section? In this section, in the third pada, he is saying that earlier you have shown viroda between one thing and the other as claimed by the Purvapakshi and due to such virodha you had set aside the argument of the Purvapakshi now he is saying that this shruti where you are trying this samanvaya they also have virodha so do you give the same treatment to shruti you should so you should set the shruti aside you have said that the virodha of the darshanikas with the समन्वय श्रुति और दी अद्वैत श्रुति इज वेर यू हैव मेड समन्वय एज दी तात्पर्य विषय ऑफ ऑल श्रुतिज देर इज नो विरोधा बिकॉज दी विरोधा ऑफ दी अप्रामाणिक और ड्यू टू दिस विरोधा ऑल्सो विषय श्रुति इज अ प्रमाण एंड वॉट यू आर शोइंग इज काउंटर बाय दी श्रुति इट्सेल्फ देर फॉर दे आर अप्रामाणिक एंड अप्रामाणिक विरोधा इज नो विरोधा विद दी प्रमाण दिस इज हाउ यूर अविरोध अध्याय has shown in the earlier two padas. In the third pada, we are going to show you virodha of the shruti among themselves. Therefore, if shruti is pramana, one shruti is pramana, the other will become apramanika. Or both will be apramana. So you have to use the same approach. Therefore, if there is a contradiction between the two shrutis, then it is not pramana. This is where the Purvapakshi is coming from. Siddhanti will answer all of these. In the next sutras, which we'll see in the next part of Siddhantastu with the 29th sutra. We'll not begin this, we'll stop in time today. Amnayante samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Namaste, thank you.